Welcome to the Holiday Wrestling Spectacular at Sold Out, vivacious, vibrant Reunion Arena here in downtown Dallas, Texas. A tremendous card of world-class championship wrestling. Kamala and David Von Erich. That's just one of the super main events. Remember this one? Kamala battling David Von Erich. David putting the iron claw, and then Akbar comes up with his whip across the back. Well, it didn't take long for David Von Erich to react to that one, or Kamala. But David Von Erich is the only man who owns a victory over Kamala. He did that with the iron claw. Kamala, the Ugandan giant. David Von Erich, the toast of Texas. And in our other tremendous event, it'll be Chris Adams. Remember the Masked Avenger? He had to come as this to gain a victory over gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And then we found out the Masked Avenger was the one and only, the man from Stratford-on-Avon, England, Chris Adams, who will have a shot at that American Heavyweight Championship with Sunshine, the former valet of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, in his corner. And the American Heavyweight Champion, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, will be battling with Precious in his corner. This tremendous world-class championship wrestling. And coming up next, it'll be Terry Gordy and Kevin Von Erich next on World Class Championship Wrestling.
World Class Championship Wrestling here at Reunion Arena. With this fabulous bout, sanctioned by the National Wrestling Alliance, one fall, a 20-minute time limit. One of the fabulous Freebirds from Georgia, 290 pounds, Freebird Terry Gordy. On the near side of the ring, in the green ring jacket, Benton County, Texas, 235 pounds, high-flying Kevin Von Erich. Bronco Lovitz, your referee.
Kevin Von Erich, Terry Gordy. Kevin Von Erich and Terry Gordy. Terry Gordy, he of the Oriental Spike. Kevin Von Erich, well, he's got an arsenal of attacks. He can use the claw, he can put the sleep hold, he can do it all. And he doesn't worry about size. He doesn't worry about giving up weight. He's right in there with the continuing feud of the Von Erichs and the Freebirds. World-class championship wrestling with Terry Gordy and Kevin Von Erich. Coming up, it'll be Kamala and David Von Erich. And the American Heavyweight Championship, Chris Adams and gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Tremendous action in world-class championship wrestling. Rocco Lovitz, referee. A crowd sitting on tender hooks as the Von Erichs go to battle. The last time out, we saw the debut and the successful debut of Mike Von Erich. And Kevin now upholding the honor and the dignity and the wrestling expertise of the Von Erich clan. Oh, tremendous move by Gordy. And then Kevin Von Erich comes out. And then he comes up with another arm drag. Kevin Von Erich colliding and crashing with a huge Terry Gordy. Kevin holding in the center of the ring now. You notice Kevin wrestling barefoot. He prefers it that way. It's a better feel for his work. That scream in the shoulder caught by Kevin Von Erich on Terry Gordy. Out in there again. And Kevin goes back to work on that left arm. Kevin Von Erich. Starting the rise to prominence of the Von Erich family after Fritz Von Erich. Like all the brothers, a fabulously successful athlete in all the major sports. always wrestling, always preparing for the day he would be stepping into his father's large footsteps. Gordy howling with pain as Kevin Von Erich drives and drives on the shoulder. Gordy trying to escape. But a tenacious Kevin Von Erich holding on. Driving on the shoulder of Terry Gordy. Fans from all over the country, from all parts of the world. As world-class championship wrestling is in all parts of the world. Oh, what a shot by Gordy right there. Kevin stepping in. Here comes Gordy up and over. Hanging on the precipice. And then kicked off. Now that's not a question of whether he threw him over the top rope. That's just helping him off the top rope. It was the impetus of Gordy that got to the top rope. It was Kevin who just helped him off. The world-class championship wrestling in all parts of the world. And fans from all parts of the world in this reunion arena. Holiday Spectacular. And another great Holiday Spectacular in the future. With Kevin Von Erich getting the adrenaline flowing from the support of his fans. He's showing the claw, showing that he wants to check the strength of Terry Gordy. Let's see who has the most, and there they are, locked in near mortal combat. Who is the stronger of the two? Kevin down low, Gordy up on top. Might really think he has the advantage, but watch Kevin. A great deal of his strength, of course, is in his legs. His ability to fly out. And he can do that so well. Now Gordy seems to think that he has charge. Kevin ducking his head in, looking. Now he comes out. Now he throws into second gear. Now Kevin takes the kick, and now he's into the combat. And there goes Gordy. And again. And back for that arm drag. Again going to work on that same shoulder that he attacked just a few minutes ago. Kevin Von Erich with Terry Gordy. Mark Lawrence reminding us that 5 minutes have gone in this bout. And after this one, it's David Von Erich and Kim Mala. Oh, stand by for that one. Because that's going to be one fraught with all sorts of adventure. From the jungle to Lake Dallas. Driving in on the hand of Terry Gordy. Gordy, who owns the Oriental Spike, perfecting that weapon with a thumb after his trip. Now it is Kevin is going after the thumb and putting it in the corner buckle, trying to anyway. And on the claw, Kevin has a claw on Gordy, and Gordy thrust him back into the buckle. Well, Kevin obviously trying to put the physical damper on the thumb of Terry Gordy. Now a knee to the jaw of Kevin Von Erich and shakes it off. And the battle and the feud of the Von Erichs and the Freebirds wears on. And roars on with a flying two, but not enough. Back on the shoulder again. Kevin looked like he had the opportunity to pull it off just a moment ago. Flying into the body slam. And pin. Let's look at that again in slow motion. Here he comes up. Driving Gordy down. He almost got him. Just couldn't quite hold him. Gordy still. Plenty of strength. But now Kevin Von Erich. Stretching the same left shoulder. Yes. Well, Gordy almost gave Bronco Livich a drop kick right there. As from Boston to the African continent, from Minnesota to Japan and on east, it's world-class championship wrestling. And this is Terry Gordy now coming up to try to take command of Kevin Von Erich. Watch this move. Watch Kevin. Oh, clothesline. Kevin fights back with a hard right hand up on the top rope. I got rope. There's Terry Gordy. Tries to get back in this bout. He has been there a bit, but it's really been Kevin Von Erich in charge, and now that double head hold of Terry Gordy. He has not managed as yet to drive that oriental spike into the neck of Kevin Von Erich. Kevin was trying to dismantle the thumb of Gordy a moment ago. The brothers Von Erich with our world-class championship wrestling. Kevin in this bout, David coming up. And Kevin doing quite a job staying with a 300-pound Terry Gordy. Staying, I should say, controlling. Confounding. And slamming the huge man. But here, Kevin turning around and the same thing on the throat of Terry Gordy. This could be a dangerous one. Oh, Kevin slamming on Gordy. I thought Gordy's going to throw him to the center of the ring. And Kevin goes after him. Kevin missing. And the oriental spike is thrust in the air. And Gordy says, oh, Gordy missed and slammed it in the mat. Kevin comes back with a claw. That's close to being a disqualification over the top rope. However, Kevin had the claw on him, so maybe that's why Bronco did not call it. Here's a suplex or attempted one. He got it. Both men shaken. Gordy looking around. Kevin shaken. You see, Kevin had the claw on Gordy, so Gordy tossed Kevin. And now it's Gordy trying to do a tight rope, 300 pounds on the top rope. I hope he comes forward. He does, and he misses. Bad timing on Gordy, great timing on Kevin. Here comes Kevin on the knees. And now reverse the poor timing. Kevin flying, landing right in the knees of Gordy, and they battle it back and forth. One, two, but not enough for three. Very close, though. Kevin shaking on that last escapade. And they continue this tremendous battle, this war of the feuds to the Von Erichs and the Freebirds. And look at Gordy. And look at Kevin's great move. And here's Kevin flying off the top rope. Kevin Von Erich beats Terry Gordy. Kevin Von Erich flying off the top rope. And here comes Buddy Roberts. And there goes Buddy. Kevin after him. Buddy Roberts coming in the ring. Now, Gordy has a cowboy boot and slams Kevin in the head. Slams Kevin in the head and again across the side of the head. Gordy slamming Kevin across the side of the head. Buddy Roberts coming in. Roberts now has the hand of Kevin Von Erich on the mat, and they're stomping on the right hand of Kevin Von Erich. Kevin needs some help. They're obviously trying to. Here comes Terry. Here comes David.
flying into the ring as Terry Gordy and Buddy Roberts, with malice aforethought, taking the shoe off, the boot off, and slamming and stomping Kevin Von Erich's right hand, trying to break his hand. Kevin Von Erich, the winner, there it is. We'll be back with an interview with David Von Erich next on World Class Championship Wrestling. Before the excitement of reunion, I had a chance to talk to David Von Erich about his bout with Kimala.
Chance to talk to David Von Erich before his match with Kimala. Now, you are the only living human being I know that has had a win over Kimala, and you've used that claw effectively on him. How do you feel about this one?
Bill, this was no different than any other match against Kimala. Kimala is a dangerous man. We all know that. Everybody knows that, from Bruiser Brody on down to the smallest man in the world. You can look at Kimala and you know he's a dangerous man. He's a man that's going to hurt somebody. But Akbar, you tried and you tried, and for 2 months you've been talking about how you are going to ban the claw. Well, the night is tonight, and the claw is here. It ain't banned, and it's going on Kamala's head. You can bet your bottom dollar on that.
I would think the last thing he would try to do is get the claw banned. That's historical with your father starting, and you've perfected it too.
Well, as we all know, and we've seen through the time, Akbar pulls a whole lot of things out of his sleeve. Akbar's not a man you can trust, and Akbar's not a man I'm going to turn my back on. And if I get a chance to grab a hold of him and put the claw on his head and bust him wide open, then Akbar, you stick your nose close enough inside that ring, because I can leave you laying right next to Kimala, and y'all be stacked just in a little line. It'd look real cute.
Hey. The beauty of this match is to take another win over Kimala. That makes it just perfect. Well, David Von Erich, the best to you in this one. Very much success.
About 20-minute time limit from the jungles of Uganda, represented by General Akbar from Devastation Incorporated, Kimala, the Ugandan Giant. Across the ring, his opponent from Denton County, Texas, 250 pounds, the Yellow Rose of Texas, David Von Erich. Rokunovich is your referee.
And I think there is no question in anybody's mind that 100% of the fans here are 100% in favor of the Yellow Rose of Texas, David Von Erich. David Von Erich, who has a victory over Kimala, the only man that we know of who's ever done that. He did it with the Iron Claw. Here is David Von Erich. The closest to an emulation of his father, Fritz Von Erich, in style and purpose and temperament and the use of that tremendous right hand. And Kimala remembers. And Kimala undoubtedly cataloged that very vividly in his mind. Those forceful forefingers and thumb crashing into his skull as Friday speaks to David Von Erich from the edge of the apron, and away they go, toe-to-toe. Kimala, not off his feet. David Von Erich after him. David Von Erich, who has beaten Kimala after another victory. Kimala, of course, seeking some revenge, and don't be surprised at anything that may occur from the Kimala Akbar camp. It will be wild, vicious, ferocious. The Ugandan Giant slashing at David Von Erich, crashing. Chopping now. The Giant using the judo chop, jiu-jitsu chop, double chop. David Von Erich to the mat. The Ugandan Giant has not been down yet. Oh, he goes into the throat with an obvious chokehold.
Rakolovich. Warning. David Von Erich crashes in the rope right above us. Oh, the Giant. Oh, he's almost off his feet. Not quite. David with a tremendous left hook. A kick, and here he goes. And he's down. At least to one knee. David Von Erich smashing the Giant down, the Ugandan Giant Kibala. Knee to the head, double chop by the Giant, looking for instructions on Friday. Friday takes the instructions from Akbar. Friday passing on the instructions from Akbar to Kibala. And Kibala goes to the attack, and David Von Erich hanging on the top rope. And the Giant biting in on David Von Erich. Kibala has David in serious trouble, just hanging there. Chop up and over and out. David Von Erich on the floor. Now the Giant, I hope, isn't going to leap onto the floor from up there. That's a concrete floor. Now Friday got there in time to stop him. So David Von Erich feeling the effects now, sagging back to the floor. The count is stopped right now as Kamala. And now the crowd picking up the chant. Here's a replay of that shot. David racked up and over the top ropes. A good thing he caught himself, or he'd have been splattered on the floor. Kibala in charge. Kibala now. Prancing around with his tribal customs of slapping his midsection. His huge bare feet stomping on the mat. And David Von Erich has a cut on his forehead. And is sagging now as the count goes on, and Friday comes up here to talk to Kibala. And once again, David is crashed across the head. Blood flowing from his forehead. I'm not sure if that's from the floor or when Kibala bit him. But Kibala going to the attack, sensing a chance for victory as he chops the chop, and David Von Erich comes fighting back. At the moment of most adversity, David Von Erich and the Von Erich family battles back. And once again, Kibala biting it on the forehead of David Von Erich. The smell of this combat that Kibala has brought on David Von Erich. Here comes Kibala, diving in one, two, and not quite enough for three. Just about, not quite enough. Friday thought the count was slow. He thought he missed him, and here's David Von Erich hiding the claw. And coming up with the claw, David Von Erich crashing in on Kibala with an iron claw. The question is, does he have enough strength to hold him there? Can he put him on his back? He has him on his knee. David Von Erich holding the claw. Akbar is standing over in the corner watching. Akbar watching the point of the finger. Friday. Akbar motioning to Kibala to get up. Now, you remember in our last adventure on World Class Championship Wrestling with Akbar, he came up with a flame on Iceman King Carson. If he does that here, he'd have to interfere in the bout. Friday is right behind David Von Erich yelling. But David Von Erich is holding the claw, and Kibala has not moved, has not been able to come up. And David had continued to put tremendous pressure on Kibala, trying to take him down. He's got him down on his back, almost on his back. Kibala bleeding now. Kibala trying to make it to the ring rope. Friday reaching for the leg. Rakolovich did not see Kibala have his leg put on the top rope or the bottom rope by Friday. And Friday now has the claw put on him. And here comes Akbar across. And Akbar slammed David Von Erich. And Akbar slammed by David. And Kamala is still on the floor. David's going to have to watch this. The bell. He wanted the bell. David Von Erich going after Akbar. But Kamala's coming up now behind him. Kamala bleeding from a cut on his forehead. Rocco Lubitsch asking for the bell. Here comes Kamala slamming David Von Erich. I think Friday, Akbar and Kamala have been disqualified. I just had that feeling because David Von Erich was interfered with. Friday is rolling off the apron. But Kamala, and now Akbar choking David Von Erich from behind. And Akbar has gone absolutely berserk. Well, here comes Carrie Von Erich. Carrie Von Erich in. Looking for somebody else to come flying over here. Akbar's in the ring now. Carrie's picked up Kamala and body slammed him. David Von Erich is having his arm raised by Brocko Lubitsch, the winner, David Von Erich. A bloodied and bashed David Von Erich is the winner. He had Kamala. Friday pulled his leg over to the bottom rope. Akbar interfered, and David survived. Akbar had made a public statement that anybody who could body slam Kamala would receive $10,000. You just noticed that Carrie Von Erich body slammed Kamala. If Kamala's a man of his word, which you'd have to question, he owes Carrie $10,000. Here is the replay of Carrie Von Erich coming around. Sliding off, picking up Kamala, no question. There is visual proof. Carrie Von Erich has body slammed Kamala. Now Kamala's back with Friday. Friday's trying to get him out of there. Akbar's trying to get him out. Kamala bleeding from his forehead. And they're trying to get him out of the ring. David Von Erich coming around, and the battle is right behind us as David Mann is trying to stop it. And everything breaking loose. We'll be back with an interview with Chris Adams next on World Class Championship Wrestling. $20,000 delirious fans here in Reunion Arena for Wrestling Holiday Spectacular. And one of those spectacular events features the Englishman, that gentleman, Chris Adams, and the American Heavyweight Champion, Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. I had a chance to talk to Chris Adams and Garvin about their bout for the American Championship. Chris Adams going for the American Heavyweight Championship. You've got sunshine in your corner, and I'm sure you feel very confident.
The reason I feel confident, Bill, is because sunshine is in my corner in order that Precious does not interfere in my match. And that's the main thing, because I know I can beat Garvin because I've beaten him before. This is the big, big night for me, and I think I can pull it off, Bill.
I feel your confidence. I know we're looking forward to this bout, and we're going to turn our attention now to what Jimmy Garvin had to say about all this.
Okay, Bill.
Well, here we are again, Bill Mercer, Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, along with thousands and thousands of wrestling fans, because everywhere Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin goes, the American Heavyweight Champion, it seems that thousands and thousands of wrestling fans gather around. The reason being that I am the American Heavyweight Champion, that I'm going to remain the American Heavyweight Champion, no matter what Chris Adams seems to think, no matter what he seems to think about that poor excuse for a woman being in his corner. Big deal, she don't have a license. She don't belong there anyway, and all these insane wrestling fans around here, and it's just about ready to come to an end.
She better stay away from me, too. She better. I hate her guts.
You know, she's been pushing her weight around here. You know, Precious just sits in the corner. She minds her own business. But tonight, we're going to take care of that phony Englishman and that poor excuse for a woman.
Thank you, Jimmy Garvin.
Reunion Arena, sold out with 20,000 wrestling fans here in Dallas, Texas. And there he is, and she is, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin, the American heavyweight champion, and his valet, Precious. Garvin decked out in, I guess it's white ermine.
This is it!
Here he comes.
This is it!
He says this
right,
is it.
Here it is!
Well, there
the
is
American
his new valet, Precious.
Champion, gorgeous Jimmy Garvin!
He is,
he's gorgeous, isn't he?
Really casually attired and sort of a Texas-style pink and purple. And here comes the exciting young man, the gentleman from England, Chris Adams. Stars on the front, stars and bars of the Union Jack, and a very, very popular young man. This is for the American Heavyweight Championship. I don't see Sunshine. Now here she comes. Sunshine, very serious-looking Sunshine. And she will be at ringside for Chris Adams. Oh, the style of this Sunshine. Look at here. They better keep those two ladies apart. Well, this could be all sorts of fighting in this one. It could be something. Here is Mark Lawrence.
You get out of here. You
don't
get out of here.
It,
I hate that.
She has no reason to be out here.
Before we turn it to Mark.
She doesn't need
to pass. 45-minute time limit for the American Heavyweight Championship. I will introduce the defending champion first. From Miami, Florida, 235 pounds, gorgeous Jim Garvin. Garvin wearing the American Heavyweight Championship belt. That belt is on the line in this bout. Assisting him in his corner, his lovely valet, Precious. Challenging for the American belt tonight. From England, 235 pounds, gentleman Chris Adams. And in his corner tonight, his second, the lovely Sunshine. All right. David Manning, your referee.
Well, we've already had a lot of heated exchanges out there, Precious and Sunshine. Garvin and Adams. There's the American, or rather the, yes, the American championship belt. Just a little background for you that gorgeous Jimmy Garvin had Sunshine in his valet. Then he decided to give Sunshine a present. So he brought in this second valet who was supposed to help Sunshine. Before we knew it, Sunshine had been deposed by the girl called Precious.
You ain't got no business.
Garvin kicked out Sunshine, and Sunshine gave Chris Adams a videotapes and film of Garvin's matches. And here is Sunshine in the Chris Adams camp. Gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Trying to protect his championship from Chris Adams, and he starts off very well. Chris in with a body slam. Right there. Adams wanted a shot at Garvin, who was defending his championship every week against everybody except maybe the top challenger. But he got Chris Adams in, and he battled Chris with a draw. And that changed Garvin's mind. He could put in the championship on the line. He wouldn't give Adams another shot. So along came somebody named the Mask Avenger and just thoroughly whipped gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. And that turned out to be Chris Adams. And also, oh, nice move by Adams. Another one. That also brought about this American Heavyweight Championship match. At the same time, Sunshine was being deposed, and that brought her into the Chris Adams camp. And that sort of historically brings you to date. Now, Sunshine working around to the far side to see if she and Precious are going to get into it over there. He just moved around to another corner. Sunshine looking down with sort of a targeted eyes at Precious. And Chris Adams continues domination of Garvin in the ring, slamming into that left shoulder. Oh, what a wild one this is. And has been all this reunion spectacular holiday feat. Look out, Garvin right here. Rolls him up, maybe a one. Who knows? Kicked him off. Chris Adams just missing the championship there. Thought he had him. We just had some spectacular news at the next holiday event and reunion. Another holiday spectacular coming up. And it's going to feature the World Heavyweight Champion, who just got this information from David Von Erich. Ric Flair defeated Harley Race. Ric Flair and David Von Erich will be battling in the next holiday spectacular in Reunion Arena for the World Championship. David Von Erich promising that this time it's going to be in Texas. As Chris Adams drives into the arm of gorgeous Jimmy Garvin. Well, Precious has moved out of another section of ring. Sunshine is they're in neutral corners now across from each other. Here comes, no, there goes Garvin. Up and hooked him, nicely done. Chris Adams up and hooked him again. Chris Adams finishing explosion is his super kick. And of course, if you have not seen it now, Sunshine kind of moving around over on the opposite side of the ring. He can get a better view of Precious over here. While Chris Adams flings Garvin. Whoop, great move by Garvin, protecting himself and taking a measure of Chris Adams. Sunshine's role, at least publicly stated, is to prevent Precious from interfering with Chris Adams. And underneath there now is Chris Adams. It looks like he's being choked. David Manning trying to feel in to see if it is. Evidently not. Chris Adams just trying to flail out of there. We'll look back at this replay as Garvin did a great job of sticking that knee into the neck, into the throat of Chris Adams. Adams in the corner. Sunshine. Look at it. Guarded Jimmy Garvin.
You want him? There he is.
There's that exchange. Now Sunshine concerned about somebody else. She used to be concerned about Garvin. Well, she was thrown over. Sunny Chris Adams now is taking a tremendous amount of punishment. And Garvin's enjoying it as he has a chance to yell and scream at Sunshine. And Sunshine leading the cheers for Chris Adams. Sunshine cheerleading. Chris Adams being forced back now. And now he is forcing Garvin up. The chin hold held by Garvin. Sunshine directly behind, as you see. Little piggyback ride and into the quarter buckle. Nice move by Chris Adams. Trying to wrest the American Championship from Garvin. Again. Again. Garvin begging for mercy, and now it is turned around. Oh, knee to the midsection, and Garvin's right back. Here comes Garvin.
Up and over. Watch this. Up and over Garvin. Chris Adams. A super kick. There goes Garvin out on the floor. And the count is on by David Manning to four. Chris Adams coming up. He wants to help Garvin back, and he pulls him up by his cold and locks. And Precious trying to help, but there goes. On top, one, two, and not three. No, Chris Adams got out of there as Precious up into them. And Precious on the run as Sunshine's after her. So it's the women around the ring. Here comes Garvin, flashed by Sunshine. One, two, three. Chris Adams, the American heavyweight champion. Sunshine after Precious. And a fight there. A heck of a fight over there. And Sunshine now is going to claw Jimmy Garvin. And Garvin escapes. And Sunshine grabbed Garvin. Sunshine slapped David Manning. And Garvin, and now Chris Adams says he is the champion. Chris Adams, the American heavyweight champion, as Sunshine grabbed Garvin. Adams put him down. And look at this pandemonium.
7 minutes, 5 seconds. Gentlemen, Chris Adams, your new
I think the sound, the pictures, the story right there. Tell it all. You could say that it was an eye for an eye because Precious upended Adams when he was trying to bring Garvin in. Sunshine chased Precious around. Sunshine did grab Garvin. Well, that just kind of evened things up. That's the finish of World Class Championship Wrestling, American Heavyweight Championship for Adams. We'll be back in a moment with more. A holiday spectacular wrestling. It has certainly been a worthwhile, exciting, stupendous event. An event here at Reunion Arena in Dallas. Well, we've seen the debut in the past couple of weeks of Mike Von Erich, a successful debut. We've seen Kevin Von Erich win, David Von Erich win, and we have seen the American Heavyweight Championship change hands. I don't know what more we could give you in excitement and thrills, but we'll try it again next time, next week, on World Class Championship Wrestling. I'm Bill Mercer. So long, world.